Hepatitis A. Inflammation of the liver caused by the hepatitis virus HAV. HAV is usually transmitted from person to person by food or drink that has been contaminated with the stool of a person with hepatitis A. This type of transmission is called fecal-oral. The virus is more easily spread in areas where there are poor sanitary conditions or where good personal hygiene is not observed. In 2003, there were hepatitis C outbreaks in the U.S. associated with eating raw or lightly cooked green onion scallions. Casual contact, as in the school, office, or another work setting, does not spread the virus. Hepatitis A can be transmitted by men, both adolescents and adults who have sex with men. Hepatitis C outbreaks among men who have sex with men have been frequently reported. The virus can also be transmitted by illegal drug users. Hepatitis C develops within 2 months of exposure to the virus. The average incubation period for the virus is 28 days, range 15 to 50 days until symptoms appear. Hepatitis A can range greatly in severity. Some persons with hepatitis A virus infection have no signs or symptoms of the disease. Older persons are more likely to have symptoms than children. In its most dire form, the disease can lead to liver failure and death. This is relatively rare. The symptoms and signs tend to appear abruptly and may include fatigue, loss of appetite, nausea, diarrhea, abdominal pain, fever, and jaundice, yellowing of the skin and eyes, and dark urine. Symptoms usually last less than 2 months. A few persons are ill for as long as 6 months. Recovery is usually complete. The diagnosis of hepatitis A is confirmed by a blood test, IgM anti-HAV. When immediate protection against hepatitis C infection is needed, immunoglobulin gamma globulin is used. Immunoglobulin is effective only if given within 2 weeks of exposure, and protection only lasts for 2 to 4 months. Immunoglobulin can be used to protect household contacts of someone with acute viral hepatitis, and by travelers who must depart for regions with poor sanitation and high hepatitis rates before vaccines can take effect. Travelers can receive immunoglobulin and hepatitis A vaccine simultaneously. Hepatitis A vaccine is used before exposure to hepatitis A virus for persons who are more likely to get the infection or are more likely to get seriously ill if they do get hepatitis A. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention (CDC) recommend the hepatitis A vaccine for persons traveling to or working in countries that have high or intermediate rates of hepatitis A, children in areas where the rates of hepatitis A were or are at least twice the national average during the baseline period of 1987 to 1997, men who have sex with men, injecting and non-injecting illegal drug users, persons who work with hepatitis A virus-infected primates or with hepatitis A virus in a research laboratory setting, people with chronic liver disease, and persons who have clotting factor disorders such as hemophilia and/or administered clotting factor.